So good morning students.
Now we are on the most important exercise as a board point of view, especially for the ICSC. All of you are the students of class 10th. So now I have to start your exercise 5E. Actually this exercise consists with the language problems. Okay, all the problems are language problems related. And you will get a 4 marks from this exercise. Okay, so that means it is very important. So now I have to start it, and in this exercise they will learn how a language problem will convert in a quadratic equation. Okay, so now I have taken the first question of your exercise 5E. In this exercise, total 28 questions this exercise contains. So I will start with the first, and by the language issues they will convert a quadratic equation. Okay, so see the first question I am going to take. The first question is: the sum of the squares of two consecutive positive even integers is 100. See the question, exercise 5E. The sum of the squares of two consecutive. Let me check my camera. There is no any light effect or no, there is no issue. So that right now I am on my question. The sum of the squares of two consecutive positive even integers is 100. Okay, so find the integers. Okay, it's a problem completely language based. So the problem is, I am again speaking, the sum of the square of two consecutive positive even integers is 100. Find the integers. This is our question. So now at first I will talk about some sentences, just like the sum of the squares of the two consecutive positive even integer is 100. This is means equal. Okay, so the sum of squares of two consecutive positive even integers. So first thing in our mind, what are the even integers? Even integers, just like 2, 4, 6, 8. That means it doesn't mean it's minus 2. Minus 2 is also even integer. Minus 4, it is also even integer. Minus 6, minus 8. So these are the, I am giving you the examples of the integers. Okay, but they are positive, not negative. So negative means we will ignore the negative integers. Our concept, our focus should be on positive even integers. So positive even integers, let us discuss. Positive, don't write on your note copy, you should understand. Positive even integers are what? 2, okay, 4, 6, okay, 8. These are the two. Okay, so the sum of the squares of two consecutive positive integers. Can you tell me here? Consecutive means 1, after 1 is what? 2, and after 2 is what? 3. So it's a sequentially. So 2 consecutive positive even integers. So can you tell me here, you have a positive even integers? Do you know what are the positive even integers? No, you don't know. Okay, so how will you start your question? It is the issue. So see the solution. You will write at first the solution. Do you know how many the sum of the squares of two consecutive, at first is in your mind, what are your two consecutive positive even integers? Do you know? No. So you have to suppose it. Okay, so let x and x plus 1, sorry, it's not x, it's x plus 2. Actually they are the even integers. They are talking about the even integers. X, suppose x is 2, then what is the next number? It's a 2 plus 2, it's a 4. Okay, because, but you can't say what is the value of x. It's a, right now it's a variable, it is behaving like a variable. So let x and x plus 2 are, how many needs? The sum of the squares of 2. So our 2 positive even integers are what? X, first is x and second is x plus 2. Let x and x plus 2 are 2 positive even integers. Okay, the first supposition has been completed. Let x and x plus 2 are 2 positive even integers. Now, according to your question, now we are on our question. The sum of the square at first, the sum of the square of the two square of the two consecutive integers. So square of two consecutive positive even integers. So your integers are this x and x plus 2. So the squares of, so square means x square and x plus 2 to the whole square. But the sum of, the sum means plus. Listen every statement, every word, every sentence. So according to question, the sum of the square of the two consecutive positive integer is means equal. I have already before this I have told you is equal 100. Any issue? No. So first, so x square plus x plus 2 to the whole square is your 100. This is your quadratic equation. Now you will simplify it. X square plus a plus b to the whole square is what? A square plus b square plus 2ab. So we will apply here. So x square plus 4 plus, it's a 4x, actually a square plus b square, b for 2, 2 to the whole square is 4, plus 2, what is the value of a? It's a x. What is the value of b? It's again 2. Because of this, I have write it down there, 4x, it's equal 100. So this will give you x square plus x square, 2x square plus 4 plus 2 to the 4x is equal 100. Okay, so simplify more. It's a 2x square plus 4x, and now we will transpose 100. Now we will transpose 100. So this will give you plus 4, and 100 will be negative. It's a minus 100 is equal 0. So now we have a 2x square plus 4x. And now listen, 4 minus 100 gives you what? It will give you what? It's a minus 96 is equal 0. Okay. So now I'm going to draw it. So what we have, a 2x square plus 4x minus 96 is equal 0. So this, now we can take here the 2 common. So if you take the here 2 common, so you will get a x square plus
4x divided by 2, this is again 2x, and minus 96 is divided by 2. This will give you what? 48 is equal 0. So can you tell me, so what is the value of x square plus 2x minus 48? This will give you what? 0 upon 2, and 0 upon 2 is already 0. Any issue? No. It's our quadratic equation, x square plus 2x minus 48 is equal 0. And now we have to solve it. How? So in my first, second and third lecture, I have introduced how will you solve the quadratic equation. So we will multiply, what is the coefficient of x square? It's a 1. So we will multiply 1 by 48. So 1 into 48 is what? It's a 48. And now we will take the LCM of 48. It's a 24. Again 12. 6. 3. And 3 1 is 3. Our target, we have to come with the 2. Whatever you can do, you can subtract, you can add. So it's a, and everything will be same as x square plus x minus 48 is equal 0. But we have to make 2 by the help of these factors. So how will you make? Okay, 3 2 is, it's a 6, and 2 2 is, 4 2 is, 8, and 8 minus 6 is already 2. By this we can make it. It's a 8. 8 minus 6, is it clear? And 8 minus 6 is already, there is no effect on the equation. So this will give you x square plus, now multiply x, 8x minus, I am removing bracket, right now I am removing because here is no, here is, if here is negative sign, that means there will be an issue, but here is a positive there, so no issue. So 8x minus 6x minus 48 is equal 0. So what is common here? X is common. So this is x plus 8, and now what, listen, which sign you will take here? You will take at first minus sign is already common, and also 6 is common, so this will give you x plus 6 is 48. And now again in this equation, what is common? X plus 8. So x plus 8 and x minus 6, this will give you value 0. So that means we have a x plus 8 equal 0, or x minus 6 is equal 0. So it's x is equal minus 8, and next is x is equal 6. So listen here, the roots of this quadratic equation is minus 8. Listen, it's a negative, positive, negative even integer, so we will ignore it, neglect it, neglect it. Why it is neglect? Why I am neglecting it? Tell me. Because x is minus 8, and our, the sum of the square of the two consecutive positive even integer, our integer should be positive but even also. So it is, x is equal, of course it is even integer, but it's not positive, it's a negative. So it is your value. So x is what? The value of x is 6. So hence you have, what you have supposed, our supposition is what? You now you will see your supposition, your supposition is what? So the, so you will write here the solution, the final solution, final solution step. So the 2 consecutive positive even integers are, what are, what we have supposed, x and x plus 2, is that, what is the value of x? Not minus 8, it is 6. 6 and 6 plus 2, this is what? So it is 6 and 8. These are the final values. And now you can check it, because how will you check it? Now tell me, what is the square? There are two values. These are the two consecutive positive even integers. First is 6 and next is 8. And the square of these digits. So 6 to the whole square plus 8 to the whole square. This will give you what? 6 to the whole square 36 plus 8 to the whole square is 64. This will give you what? 100. And the sum should be 100. You, in this way you can check it if you want to check. Okay. You can verify. So now, this is your perfect solution. If you have any issue, today I will explain only single question and question number 2nd, 3rd and 4th. I will give it to you for the homework. Okay. So, 0 marks.